So to be in court unopposed, meaning the opposing counsel has brought even one expert, much less two, three, or four. If you don't have an expert, forget the facts. There's just that appearance. There's the showmanship of what occurs in trial. It's unbalanced. It looks like you could produce someone to defend your side. So you've already got one strike against you. And that's before we get the facts of the case, whether you're just being deprived of justice for renewing the true facts of what occurred, having someone really look through it impartially and say what's here and what's not. So we see that happen fairly routinely. And it's particularly common in the area of child abuse. So what occurs in child abuse is obviously there is, by definition, an injured child. So a child has some pattern of trauma. And the question is, really at its core, is that what's called inflicted trauma, meaning brought on by someone else's hand, or is it accidental trauma? So if we just bridge it right there, kind of make a Y, it's either inflicted or it's accidental. So the presumption, obviously, in child abuse is that it's inflicted. That's how we got there.
Because the child couldn't have inflicted it on himself.
Because the child couldn't have inflicted it on himself would be one thought. And then by the time it's in a legal construct, it's because somebody has informed child protective services, law enforcement is involved. So we're already at the point where someone's saying this is child abuse. So by the time that we've gotten there, the odds are a little bit stacked against you because people have already taken it through a few different medical levels and now law enforcement is involved as well.